accent. What other accent?
My mom.
I was confused.
impressive. Shit never looks so good. You look amazing tonight. You're all sparkly and puffy in the right places. Highlights everywhere they need to be, and lowlights perfectly placed. Oh, how are you feeling? We have survived the long thaw. It's time to wear a tank. I'm loving it, right? Isn't it great to walk in New York City in this beginning of summer? And everybody's like, oh, I remember sex. I've been in a sleeping bag so long. It's a sleeping bag coat that costs $450. Oh my goodness. So yes, I am Lady Rizo, for those of you that... You can call me Rizzo, you can call me Riz, whatever. There's some rules at my show, though. When I touch this explosion of dead follicles coming out of my skull, I want you to make a noise as if you were excited to be alive. You can just fake it, button up, okay? He's like, I'm not gonna kiss, I'm not gonna catch your kiss. I don't do that on a first date, it's okay. Okay. We'll get there. By the end. Double fist and sparkle fingers. Okay, so I touch my hair and make a noise, and then when I touch my cleave, this chasm between my breasticles, I want you to shut the fuck up. So hair noise and stop on the tits, just like I tell my lover, stop on the tits for just a little bit too near Tokyo. Light percussion of the shaker of the bartender. Okay, just adding that now. It feels so tropical. Oh, okay, right. Okay, I think God, you guys are so ready. What did you all go to acting class before this show? Like, we warmed up together, and it's up on 42nd Street in 10th. But then we all came in a school bus, and we're ready. So, I think you're ready for next levs. When I touch the hair, I want you to make a noise like I've taken off your sandals or heels or boots or whatever you're wearing tonight, and I've blown lightly into your toenails, and that's lifted into a colored swell that's eased your aching knees, thigh muscles, gonads. Swirled up into your solar plexus, bubbled around your heart and out your mouth in a joyful holler that's in the color of your choice. Vom it up, that spirit. Rainbow vom. Hashtag. And then when I touch le grand petit téton, I want you to not only be quiet, but go deep into a Zen monastic silence. Some rules for complicated metropolitans. Some Jews having trouble with the Zen. Wait, you're getting a little too spiritual, right? Let's keep it three times a year, okay? And then let's eat.
Quizás,
Días y que son los días. Y yo desesperando. Desesperando, tú contestando. So if you really love me, say yes. But if you don't, the other to confess. And please don't tell me. Kisses, kisses. Kisses, kisses. Kisses, kisses. Further out there. You really look like a Jean-Paul Gaultier extra. I like my men looking like French criminals. So I just want to get a geographical poll, and I don't want like states or areas, but I want to know how many people were raised on the ocean. Like on a prairie, like flatlands. All right. And what else is there? Mountains. Okay, we've got some mountains here. And then are there any desert people? Okay. Just that one, okay. And this really feeds into what I wanted to say next, which is I was born in a very, very wet place in the Northwest. Extremely wet, like seriously, creaming every, like God was just creaming over everything where I was born, jizzing all over the land, and very fertile moisture, you know, like a lot of moisture. And so I always had this kind of fear of the desert, because I'm just like, things die there, and sand gets in your eyes. I've had this kind of secret little fear that I hadn't really dealt with until this year, but I just got back from the motherfucking Joshua Tree Desert. And it is succulent. And this is a song that is a new song. It's a new song that I wrote with Ryder here. Yeah, cheers for the newness. Treat, because I am, you know, the only way to grow as a person is to make risks, take risks, and step off bridges and lakes all the time. Step off lakes, please. just like Jesus, just stepping onto the lake. And so this show, I have three new songs that I haven't really performed in my shows before. They're originals. Newness! This is a song that's inspired by a Stephen Crane poem. Thank you. Bonbon. She's helping me tonight, everybody. With things and people, and I just seem super tired. I can't sit by myself. I just want to sit on you, Gigi. She's really strong, and her hand is really where it counts. Oh my god! Oh, wow. Really likes to muscle me around. Okay, fixing her up. Okay, so, was anybody alive during the 1990s? Yeah. Towards the end of the decade. Yeah, the whole thing. So, I somehow missed, I mean, I listened to him, but I somehow missed this amazing video that I posted about on the social needs the other day. A D'Angelo video called Untitled. And and I was at a party, and you know, someone said, "Oh, you know that D'Angelo video for Untitled?" I was like, "Oh no, I've never seen it." This was a woman who was like, "Stop the party. We need to put this on right now." You know, and like all good children of the 21st century, we gathered around the Google, and I watched this video, and it is basically like having sex with D'Angelo in 1998. He fucks you, and he really does. And I had such a vocal response that the whole party gathered around, and I was really interested. I said, you know, straight men, hetero men, I have a question for you. Watch this video, and does it give you the slightest bit of erection? Just a little erection. I just wanted them to be honest with me, and most of them were honest that it is actually really, it's a really sexy example of man meat. He does things like lick his lips, and it's not in a funny way. His lips are, he's wetting his lips for you. It's so good. Okay, so I'm sorry, I'm not just going to talk about a YouTube video for a half hour. But I really, after seeing this video, felt like it. So it kind of I went on a little D'Angelo trip, and trip down D'Angelo's lanes, and swerved all over the place. And then I remembered this song, and I thought, I want to do this song. So we're going to stay in the dark realm. Thank you. Bring that monster to the English thing. You don't even know what's happening until you're in that orange jumpsuit. So, how do you like this gown? Something that's thrown over my naked body and cinched around my waist. But I'm ready to get really tough for that. I'm ready for another look. Change is upon us. It's almost summer. And some of you, most of you, probably know what happens when I want to change. I throw plates! I break shit! I ask a stranger, someone who I don't know personally and I've never shared fluids with, those are two separate things, to come help me with a couple zippers and perhaps a personal story. Me? I hear, who's the one saying me?
Me back here!
Okay, me back here. Because of that falsetto, I just hope you talk like that.
Hi, my name's Sam.
Oh, sparkle, sparkle face. So we're gonna play a little game. It's called Stalker and Diva, and I'm gonna get behind there, and I want you to really creepy walk to there, but don't take forever because I don't have all day. Put your face in a little puck.
Oh my God, Riz.
Oh, Nick.
Nick was his name.
Sure, yeah.
Nick. I put my boots back on.
It's like where most women go to like put in a, you know, a birth control device. Yeah. You're like, hold on, I gotta go in the bathroom.
Yeah.
I put my boots back on.
Yeah, no, I put my boots on. I was like, I put my boots on. And he was like, whatever you want.
Okay.
And then we did it. And I remember I wore this like really big necklace, and it was like moving around a lot, and like that was fun too.
Wait, so you're like boots and necklace?
Yeah.
And was the actual sex good?
No. But I knew, like, I kind of figured it was like,
yeah.
It was 5:30 in the morning, and like,
right,
you know,
right.
Yeah.
And so, did you ever see him again?
No, well, I think I found his MySpace profile at some point. But no, I was thinking he could be here, Nick?
And so, then the next times that you had were?
Oh, a fireman.
Really?
Yeah, that was fantastic.
Oh.
FDNY, everybody's here, God bless them.
Wait, I've never had sex with a fireman.
I think every fireman that I've had sex with has been.
Wait, how many firemen have you had sex with, Laura?
Just two that I know
of. Oh. You're like some other maybe secret firemen?
Yeah.
Who are just like undercover,
yeah, exactly.
Because they're protecting,
yeah,
the world.
Exactly, and fires.
And fires?
Yeah.
Wow, so you've almost got a whole calendar.
Yeah, almost, yeah. I look at the calendar every year just in case one of them is in it.
Oh, let's go to,
yeah,
Staten Island together. I want you all to give this beautiful woman, Laura, a round of applause. Far from. The clicking of glasses, the gossips and video, clashing with unions and texts at me, winnings and dollars, and bobbing and current and fashions, the brassies and polyps are wagging their gashes. What's the newest? Who's the cutest? Where's your money? Kill the foolish. Just a hint, a glam, a taste, a glance, I'll overdose on your romance. Aeroplane is sweeter with you. Thank you. couple of white chicks. Lauren Hill, before she went crazy. Has she got her mind back? Has anyone seen her perform lately? She all right?
Yeah.
Oh, no. All the best ones go, and really, someday it's gonna be me. So I didn't properly get to introduce my band yet. This man who's plugging in a beautiful instrument is Yair Evni. He's just sexy, and he travels the world with me, and he's the musical director of tonight, and we also wrote Ink Dead together and Bittersweet together.
Nice!
And, you know, this next song, which is new, another new one. Just jumping off lakes tonight. So many lakes to jump off of. So many mountains and lakes. We're the mountain people. About states and just start talking about geographical features. I'd like to introduce the rest of my band who will be patiently watching while this song is happening. This is handsome Benjamin Campbell on the bass. Is that Wax talking about me tonight? Oh, excellent. Benjamin is holding down the Gentile portion of the band. He's milky, and he can eat dairy. Yeah, so we gave him all the, I got a cheese platter, and all the other Jews were like, oh, no, no. And he's like, I'm made from cow's milk. So he's, you know, totally not gassy tonight. This is Yuval Lyon. And then sharing my genetic makeup over here, half Scotch, half Jew, Matt Ray. We're both incredibly frugal. Frugal. So occasionally I get fun little things to do with theater companies and the civilians theater company, some theater people. They do a really cool project where they take a theme and then they do interviews of people based on that theme, which are usually surrounded in sex and death. They really love sex and death. And so they just always, you know, throw that my way, sex and death. So they asked me to write a song, and I was given a recording of an interview with a freaky vegan who lives in San Francisco, and she was part of a night where she got into a coffin and was buried and had sex. The interview was why she did that and why she wanted to, and people watched, and there was a night cam. So then I was given that interview, and then this is the song. be reborn out of this suffering. There's air just enough to be clear. I decided this show. I've been, you know, I've been touring the world a lot. My next little jaunt is in New Zealand, so if you have any Kiwi friends, you know, fuzzy on the outside, green inside, send them my way. I'll be in Auckland. And then I promise I will come back. I promise, because I really do love you. I love you. Why do you need to tour the world when you live in New York City? So, because we are the world. We are the children. This is, this is one of my favorite songs, and I decided to just the show do a lot of new stuff and then a lot of favorite things and not even question if it was crafty or hip. Let's do it, right? Yeah, let's do it. Everybody wants to hear Lauryn Hill, right? So, and it's vintage now. This is one of my favorite love songs, and I think it's because it's got such a shell of pain, and love is the sweetest fruit that has a shell of pain. It's about hope also, in new beginnings. Here's to all your new beginnings. Shattered dreams, worthless years. Here am I, encased inside a hollow shell. Life began, then was done. Now the sights our eyes behold will empty out our merging hearts and feed our empty soul. Thank you. If you're crying enough in the dark, like you hear the song of freedom.
It's the main song of freedom.
Meeting the dreams of the girls and the queens and the men and the boy chicks and in-betweens. All their feelings are busy and away. Send that towards my body. get even quieter. Like everybody make a real quiet shh. Maybe we even go back before humans were on the land. And here we are. And maybe right now you realize why you made yourself go into the East Village and take the subway and wait in a line and find a seat and maybe sit on a seat that's not too comfortable. And sit waiting for a woman to enter the stage, and she was 12 minutes late, I'll give you that. And now, perhaps we have an acknowledgement of making these efforts to then sit in a safe space. Though there was an emergency flood warning today, it seems as if it's dry outside. And you're in the arms of a loving, self-proclaimed diva. A decided priestess of the cabaret. And I hold you in my arms. And I will hold you forever. And this will never go away. And in the darkness, I will hear your voice. Through the fog, you know you have no choice. actually, really quickly, I have a fun little advertisement. So artists do this thing called merchandise, and that's so they can eat and live. And I resisted.
No.
But finally, I've got tank tops, everybody! Gigi Bonbon is modeling a male tank top right now. This is great for summer. It has low armpit holes to show off your hairy pits and your, pecs or, just your flesh. Bodies, any kind of bodies can fit in this. I have every size. She's holding tote bags, black and white, with my face, so you can carry me everywhere. And then Gigi, what do you've got underneath? Something for the ladies, perhaps? Oh, it's a nether shirt. Didn't you always want my eyes right underneath your breasts? Or on your breasts, depending on how you wear it, really, if you wear it high or low. I'm looking at you. Thank you, Gigi Bonbon. Gigi Bonbon, everybody. The ass is not the same. You can't afford that shit. One more song? It is such an honor to play with this band. These are some really, really fun musicians. To show you the singer, and I was nine. Did I say that? No, that was about right. And it was a weird art and science festival, but they had this big singer on that my parents really wanted me to see. And I watched her up on stage, and I was like, "That's one bad motherfucker." I didn't think like that because I didn't have those words really yet. But I thought that is something I want to be. She seems like a mean lady. Like. Really good, and she knows it. And that was Etta James. And I thank Etta for giving me that path that I could be a bad, righteous bitch.
I'm gonna make it.
seventh hour, on the seventh day of the month of September, seventh doctors say, they say you are pregnant.